Hello class 10, good morning. In chapter 3 in the RH programming, today we are going to discuss programming question number 1, programming question 5.1. So the question is, write a program in Java, question number 5.1, write a program in Java to store 20 numbers. To store how many numbers? 20 numbers. Including even and odd, some even number, some odd number, but not the zero, in a single dimensional array. Calculate and display the sum of all even numbers and all odd numbers separately. So the question is, to input any 20 numbers in an array including even number and odd number but not zero, and calculate and print sum of even numbers and sum of odd numbers separately. And how many numbers to be input in the array? 20 numbers. We have to accept 20 numbers in the array. So let us see the program. Question 5.1. Import java.util.scanner. Class name, public class even odd. Public class even odd. Public static void main spinner created the scanner class. See the declaration of the array. Int array name is A. You can have any name A, N, A equal to new int 20. Now see, this time the size of the array is 20. Why 20? In the question it is asked to accept 20 numbers, to input 20 numbers. So when this line will execute, compile, so what will happen? It will occupy a memory space in the computer and divide the whole part into 20 part. The 20 part means the first part will be A0, then A1, then A2, A3, A4, A5, A6, A7, A8, A9, A10, up to A19. Up to what? A19. So the subscripts are A0, A1, A2. Index are A0, A1, A2, A3 till A19. 0 to 19, 20 elements. Okay. Now, int I, index variable, L equal to A dot length. Already about length function I have taught you, the length function is used to find the length of an actual array counting from 1. How many elements are there? How many numbers are there in the array? So how do you write? Dir type int variable length equal to array name without square bracket, only array name. Array name is A dot length, and in the length you don't put the bracket. If you put the bracket in the length, then that function will find out the length of a string, not an array. This is the main difference, you always remember. So just write the name of the array dot length, and this will find out the length of an array. So length of the array will be 12. Int SE, sum of even equal to 0. SO, sum of the odd equal to 0. Two variables taken according to push. Now, inputting numbers in the array, accepting the numbers in the array. For I equal to 0, I less than L, the L value will come 19, no 20, sorry. The L value will come 20, length will come 20. For I equal to 0, I less than 20. The loop will run from 0 till 19. Look here, loop will run from 0 till 19. System or println, enter a number. Message will come, enter a number. Suppose you have pressed 5. So AI equal to, AI means A0 equal to 5. So this 5 will be stored in A0 place. Again go for the next type, enter a number. Enter a number, suppose you have pressed 8. Press the enter key. So at A1 place, 8 is stored. At A1 place, 8 is stored. Next I will be 2. enter a number. A2 equal to in dot next. In dot next. Again, suppose you have input 19. So this 19 will be stored at A2 place. Again, go for the next time. Enter a number. Suppose you have done 10. So 10 will be stored at A3 place. Again, enter a number. Suppose 7. 7 will be stored at A4 place. Like this, it will run for how many times? 20 times, and you will be asked to input 20 numbers one by one. Press the number, press enter key. Like this, we have to press the 20 numbers, and the numbers will be stored from A0, A1 till A19. So array is created. We have got 20 numbers, 20 elements in the array A. Now, according to question, find the only sum of the even number and sum of the odd number separately. Again, we run the same loop. I equal to 0, I less than length, I plus plus. If I value is 0. If A 0, that A 0 plus what is there? 5 is there. So 5 is divided by 2. We are using modulus operator to check the remainder. 5 is divided by 2, and if the remainder is equal to 0, that means it is an even. So A 0 is 5. So 5 is divided by 2. Remainder is 0. The first number is 5. If you divide 5 by 2, remainder is 0. No, remainder is not 0. Remainder is 1. So else part will execute. So sum of odd number equal to 0. The sum of odd number equal to 0. So 0 plus AI. AI means 5. 5 is added. Okay. Again, go for the next I. The next I is 1. If A1, so A1 plus what is there? A1 plus 8 is there. What is there? A1 plus? A1 plus 8 is there. 8 modulus 2 equal to 0? Yes. When you divide 8 by 2, remainder is 0. So it is true. The sum of even equal to sum of even plus 8. So the sum of even value is 0. The 0 plus 8. Again, go for the next I. Next I will be A2. So A2 plus what is there? 19. So 19 modulus 2 equal to 0? No. The S part will execute. S sum of odd equal to sum of odd plus 19. Plus 19 is added. Again, go for the next I. Next I will be 3. If A3, look here, at A3 plus what is there? 10 is there. So 10 modulus 2 equal to 0? Yes, 10 modulus 2 equal to 0. So 10 will be added in SE. SE means sum of even. So plus 10 is added. Again, go for the next time. Next time will be 4. If A4 is 7. 7 modulus 2 equal to 0? No. The else part will execute. 7 will be added in sum of odd number. Plus 7. Now I think I am clear. Like this, one by one, it will take all the numbers. If it is divisible by 2, that means it is even number, it will add it in sum of even SE. And if it is remainder is not 0, then this will be added in SO, means sum of odd number. So like this loop will continue for 20 times. We will pick up one by one number and find the sum of even or odd according to if condition. So after completing for 20 times, it comes out of the loop and prints sum of even number equal to SE and prints sum of odd number equal to SO. So this was your first programming question from the exercise. Question was to write a program to accept 20 numbers in an array and find the sum of even and odd. Once again, you see, when you declare the array, we have declared the array of size 20. Found the length, declare the variable, sum of even, sum of odd. We have input the 20 numbers in an array one by one like this way. Then, again we run the same loop. We are picking one by one number, dividing by 2. If remainder is 0, then adding into SE means sum of even, otherwise adding in odd, sum of odd. So this was our first array programming from the exercise, write and practice. Thank you.